Continuing with the topic introduced last time, namely the study of higher homotopy groups, let us now introduce the so-called relative homotopy groups. This module 16 has been divided into two parts because it's slightly lengthy. The idea is that I would like to take you a little deeper here, to the extent that more study of homotopy groups is not possible within our limits unless we use homology and cohomology theories. So at that door, I am going to leave you. So let us do a little more of higher homotopy groups here. Given a topological pair XA, with a base point X naught belonging to A. Sometimes I may forget to write down this base point, that's all. But it is always there in the mind, okay? Whenever you are discussing homotopy groups, pi 1, pi 2, etc. Okay? Let us consider the following subspace of all paths in X, namely continuous functions from closed interval I to X. So this is the function space. It has, remember, it has a compact open topology. So now I am writing a subspace which I am going to denote by omega X A X naught. This omega is usually denoted for loops and paths in spaces in algebraic topology. So all omega belong to x power I, that means a path from I to x. The starting point of omega is x naught. And the end point must be inside A. A is a subset. Okay, so that is omega x A x naught. It is a subspace of x power I. For n greater than or equal to 1, we will have this notation. Pi n of xa, which is a short form from pi n of xa x naught. Okay, it's a lazy notation, that's all. So the base point is always there. It is equal to pi n minus 1 of this space, omega xa x naught, with base point for this one is a constant function at x naught, a constant loop at x naught, where Cx0 is a constant path at x0. So take that, take the n minus 1th homotopy set. For n equal to 1, this will be just a set, you remember that. For n greater than or equal to 2, this will be pi 1, pi 2, and so on. They are all homotopy groups. So that is the just the definition. Okay. For n greater than or equal to 2, pi n of xa is a group which is abelian if n is greater than or equal to 3. This is what we have seen last time. These are called the relative homotopy groups of the pointed pair xa x0. Of course, if x0 is changed, you know how to relate them and so on. So there is some relation, but the groups will be different. So that is why the base point has to be mentioned. For n equal to 1, in general, it is not a group. We treat it as a set, but a special kind of set, a set with a base point. The base point of the set itself is now a constant path. Okay, it's a set with a base point. Whereas a group also has a base point, and that is the trivial element of the group. Okay, that is a pointed set. Here now is a group structure, but pointed set, that is there. So for n greater than or equal to 2, there are canonical bijections of the homotopy sets. Pi n of xa x0 can be thought of as homotopy classes of these triples, in. In is I cross I, n times, boundary of in, and P is standard notation 0 0 0. Okay, going into maps, going into IN, going into X, boundary of IN goes to A, P is always goes to X naught, and they are all corresponding homotopies. When you take homotopy class, when you take IN cross boundary of IN cross P, comma P cross I, so IN cross I is inside I, boundary of IN cross I is inside A, P cross the whole of I must be a single point. That is the meaning of this notation. So this homotopy set is the same thing as pi n of x, x naught. We have defined in a different way. Remember that. So pi n is defined as this one. Okay. So immediately when you define like this, it's automatically group structure. Here, you don't know. You have to still define group structures and so on. That is a cumbersome method, but this description is much simpler. Okay, it is just like what you wanted, whatever you wanted. Okay, only the second coordinate, second entries here are extra. Otherwise, it is just IN boundary of IN X comma X naught. Right, that would have been a definition of pi n. So pi n of x is this one extra. Okay, so that is one. Okay, there's one relation here that this is a canonical bijection. It's another one, pi n of x, x naught is also equal to somewhat complicated looking, but this is a very useful thing. Pay attention to this. IN boundary of IN, and then instead of just single point 0 0, I am taking IN minus 1 cross 0 union boundary of IN minus 1 cross I. All this is a subset of boundary of IN, and it also includes P cross 0 0 0 is already there. This P point is also there. So it's a larger set going into X naught. So take only maps which take this larger set going to X naught, boundary of IN go to A and IN going to X, of course, only take such maps and their homotopies. These two are equivalent, and both of them are equivalent to pi n minus 1 of omega x A. That is the definition of this one. So this is a statement of theorem 1.18, which gives you three equivalent way of looking at pi n of x A. Okay. Let us prove this one. So let us have a temporary notation for this big set. Set is IN minus 1 cross 0, boundary of IN minus 1 cross. There is a third subset here. So this I am denoting by Z. Okay. We know that this Z included in the boundary of IN is a cofibration, because this is just a subcomplex. Okay, remember, boundary of IN has this is a subset boundary of IN minus 1 cross I union IN minus 1 cross 0 and IN minus 1 cross 1. That is the full boundary. So what is missing? Only IN minus 1 cross 1. One of the faces is missing here. You take a cube, okay, take one of the faces and look at all the other faces. So that's what is happening here. And that is a included boundary of IN is a cofibration. This we have proved in part one actually. Not only that, this Z is contractible. So that's also easy to see. It's like a, on the sphere, it's like a half disk, half sphere. It's like that. That is contractible. Consider the quotient map Q from boundary of I to boundary of IN by Z. So here, Z to boundary of IN is a cofibration and is contractible. You are collapsing it. Okay? Therefore, this is an equivalence, this is a amount of equivalence, which we identify, okay, where z is to a single point z. Okay, so that is the meaning of this quotient map. Only all the points of z are equivalent to every other point of z. So that is the equivalence relation here. Okay, so that is what we keep saying, collapse z to a single point. From theorem 0.6, this is reference you can have from our part 1 course. Okay, so I will just give you this reference here and show you. So this is what it is. So A to X is a cofibration, and A is contractible, then the quotient map is a homotopy equivalence. Okay, so this was the theorem. All right, let's go back now. Okay, so it's a homotopy equivalence, this quotient map. Take lambda from boundary of In by Z to boundary of In as a homotopy inverse of Q. Okay, so what is the meaning of that? Lambda composite Q and Q composite lambda are homotopic identity of the respective spaces. By composing it with a rotation of boundary of In, boundary of In is nothing but Sn minus 1. And Sn minus 1, you can have a rotation which takes any point to any other point. Therefore, you can assume that lambda of the single point Z is the point P, which is 0, 0, 0. Lambda is a fixed homotopy inverse. You don't know where Z goes. If Z goes here, fine. Otherwise, you just rotate it, and then you put lambda equal to this one, boundary of Z. Now you take put eta equal to lambda composite Q. OK? So lambda is, look at this one, lambda is boundary of Z to boundary of In, and Q is from boundary of In to this one. So what you get, lambda composite Q is from boundary of In to boundary of In itself, and we know that it is homotopy equivalent to identity map. Therefore, it is homotopy equivalent, and it's one. Okay, so eta, lambda composite Q, is a homotopic to the identity map and sends the entire of Z, Z is a set under lambda, it is going to a single point. Under Q, the Z goes to the single point Z here. The whole set goes to the whole set. So under composite, so this eta sends the entire Z to a single point, and yet it is a homotopy equivalence from the boundary of In to boundary of In. This is what is the point you have to understand. Now, whenever you have a map from Sn to Sn, Sn minus 1 to Sn minus 1, you can extend it by a cone construction to Dn to Dn. So that's what we do, that eta hat be the extension by taking cone construction In boundary of In to In boundary of In. Automatically, this will be also a homotopy equivalence. It's actually a homotopy identity map. Okay, it's stronger than saying homotopy equivalence. And sends the entire of Z to a single point. Now you already, why I'm doing all this, now you automatically have appreciated why I am doing this. This whole thing, you know, can be treated as a single point, like this. That's the idea. Okay? Optohomotopy, of course, everything is optohomotopy. Therefore, eta hat induces a bijection, eta hat prime, eta hat star, from In boundary of INP to XA X naught. Suppose you have mapped here into XA X naught. Okay. Then by composing with eta hat, you will get a map from In boundary of In as it is, this whole thing going to a single point P. Okay, so omega goes to omega composite eta hat. That is the map from the first set to second set. These are all function spaces. So that is a bijection. Automatically, this composition is under, you know, under function space topologies. It is if eta is continuous, composite decomposing this will be continuous. So this is a this is not just a bijection, it is a homeomorphism. Right now, we are going to use it only as a bijection. Under the exponential correspondings, the latter space is actually equal to this, what you have to see. Why we have taken this one? This is the same thing as maps from in minus 1 boundary of in to omega xa x0. Remember, what is omega xa x0? These are all paths in x starting at x0 with endpoint in a, right? Look at a function from in minus 1 to here. Under the exponential correspondence, it will correspond to a map from in to x, okay? So fixing a point x, you have a path x cross I. The starting point is x0. That is in minus 1 cross 0 goes to x0. The end point is inside A, so that is already, you know, whatever path cross I, that is going to inside A. Okay, so that is not a problem. Boundary of in also goes inside A. Okay, more important is this entire thing going into boundary of in, okay, boundary of in. On boundary of IN, the maps are here going to CX0. It's a constant map. Okay, therefore, this boundary of IN cross I goes into CX0. Okay, by the very definite boundary of IN here goes to single point, constant path. Therefore, this whole thing going to X0 here. Okay, so this is the meaning of this set. This set is under current and is same thing as this set. Okay. So this implies over 7. So why we have got this one? That is 7. Directly as sets themselves, they are same. When you take homotopy classes, okay, if you have two spaces which are homeomorphic, then if you take path components, these are nothing but homotopy classes are path components. Path components are in one correspondence. So gives you 7. Okay, now 6 is one step further, namely, since eta hat is a homotopic triad in T of U, upon taking path component, we get 6. Okay, the functoriality of these bijections follows from the fact that everything is happening in the domain and has nothing to do with the topological pair x, x naught. What is the meaning of this? Suppose you have y comma b comma x. Okay, a map from here to here composed with that map xa to yb will give you another map there. Okay, now if you have another space, so z comma c comma that one, some function f and g and so on, all these things composition is taking on one side. The map from here to here, this composition or changing of this from here to here, etc., is taking on the domain. Therefore, they have, because of the associativity of the composition, the functoriality of these isomorphisms follows. Okay, so this will be explained completely, not exactly this one, when you study the functors and categories and so on. Okay, after that you come back and see whether it makes better sense for you. Okay, so 6 gives us an alternative definition of pi n of x is not, which is easy to remember and useful. However, with this definition, define the group structure on it will be somewhat difficult as compared to definition, the first definition 1.21, wherein the pi n's are automatically defined as groups, right? Pi n minus 1 of some other space. So 7 is just an elaborate description of what is happening in the function space x power I. But that is also useful. So you can keep all the three in your mind. Okay, so that is just the definition so far, okay? Now, take a special case when A is x naught. It follows that from this definition now, 6-1, if A is x naught, boundary of I n goes to single point. Then P going to single point is redundant. Okay, so you can as well write I n boundary of I n x comma x naught. Right? So that is the same thing as pi n of x, x naught, x naught. Which is what? Which is just pi n of x naught, x, x naught. Okay, so that is the conclusion here. Okay, so pi n of x a, x naught is equal to pi n of x naught, it's pi n of x naught. Okay. We can now state and prove one of the most fundamental results in homotopy theory. Given a pointed topological pair XA, we shall use the notation A included in X, X naught is, you know, this is pairs, that's all. X naught included in XA, so this is by J and this is by I. These in turn induce respective inclusion maps when you pass on to the loop spaces, the function spaces. Omega A x naught instead of all path is in A with certain property, right? Starting at x naught, right? So you compose, you know, if path is here, compose with I, think of this inclusion map, it can think of this as a path in X. So it will give you omega XX naught, this inclusion map. Similarly, omega XX naught can be thought of as omega XAX naught. Okay, so these are loop spaces. This is path, end point could be any point inside A. Okay, so these are the inclusion maps, which we shall denote again by I and J. All right. Consider the evaluation map. You see, X is a path. This X could express to I is a path from this path space is from, right, from I to X. All the starting point is X naught, right? You can take that one. End point is important for us. Look at the end point here. E1 of omega. This evaluation omega 1. Okay, so that's a map from x power I to x. Now, given alpha from I n minus 1 to omega x a, you take even composite alpha of I n minus 1 will be inside A, because that is the definition of omega x a. Endpoints are inside A. Therefore, we have a homomorphism boundary. I am denoting this one. It is induced by even composite alpha, okay? We are taking a simplified notation. This is classical notation anyway. Pi n of xa, okay, remember this is homotopy classes of maps like alpha. Okay. Two, you get a map from I n minus 1 to A, so that will represent pi n minus 1 of A. So the definition of boundary of alpha is nothing but the class of even composite alpha. Okay, using definition says, it's clear that boundary of alpha is nothing but just alpha restricted to boundary of I n. The last coordinate restricted to boundary of I n on the boundary, okay, if you think of this as maps from I n minus 1 cross I, so that's I n, so boundary of I n is 1. Okay. For any pointed topological pair, there exists a long exact sequence of groups and homomorphism induced by this topological pair using the I, J and DABA. So all these three will be occurring again and again, and they will be forming a chain, an infinite chain of homotopy groups. And this is the homotopy groups. Pi n of A, the first one is inclusion map, I check, inclusion induced. Then J check, inclusion induced. Then boundary. Here, for the sake of accommodating the entire thing in a single line, I have omitted mentioning the base points. The base points are there, okay, always. These are all homotopy groups for n greater than or equal to 2. So these are groups and homomorphisms. What is the meaning of exact sequence? Any two compositions are zero, that is fine, but it's stronger than that. Kernel of J check is equal to image of I check. Kernel of DABA is equal to image of J check. Kernel of I check is equal to image of DABA check. This should happen at every group here. Goes on from for n greater than equal to 2, they are homomorphisms. And keep coming down, n minus 1, n minus 2, and so on. Last thing will be pi n of x a, pi naught of x. This is a group, okay? But this is not a group. This is not a group. So what is the meaning of exactness here? Remember, that is why. Remember, these sets are pointed sets. So there is a constant function here, which is the base point. Okay. So constant function here, again base point here. These also base point, constant function. So constant function goes fine. Everything which goes to constant function, that's a kernel, must be the entire image of DABA. Similarly, everything which goes to the constant function under DABA must be entire image of J check. That is the meaning of this sequence is exact. Okay. Kernel and image can be defined when you have pointed sets. So let us prove this. Obviously, the proof will be divided into three parts, namely exactness set here, exactness here, exactness here. Okay, so one by one. The proof is broken into three steps. The first step is kernel of J check is equal to image of I check. Kernel of J check here, the I check will come from here, this one. J check and I check. So pi 1 of x. Okay, so start with an element alpha in pi n of x, which is by definition pi n minus 1 of omega x naught, represented by a map I a alpha from I n minus 1 to omega xx naught, where this alpha itself is I composite beta for some beta from I n minus 1 to omega xa. That is, you are taking an element here which is the image of I check. Alpha is I check of beta. I have to show that J check of that is zero. That will show that the image is contained in the kernel. Okay, that's one part. The second part will be proving that kernel is contained in the image. Okay, so let us prove that image is contained in the kernel. So I have picked up this alpha such that alpha is I composite beta. We have to show that alpha is in kernel of J. Just define a homotopy H of XT S equal to beta ST SX. S is a real number between 0 and 1. Okay, S and T. X is an element of this IN minus 1 or IN wherever. Okay, so beta of SX. Makes sense. Okay, beta of SX is a path operated upon T. So this h is a map from I n minus 1, the first slot is x, cross I, second slot is t, then it's a path in x, so it operates upon again an element 0 to 1. Okay, so gives you a path in omega xa. So why it's a path in omega xa? Put s equal to 0, what is this? It's beta 0 of t. The beta 0 of t is always a constant function. So that's a point x naught. Put s equal to 1, it is beta x of t. Beta is taking values inside A. Therefore, the endpoints are inside A. So that is the meaning of this. So this is the way you have to verify. Okay, so verify that h from I n minus 1 cross I to omega x A is a homotopy of the constant loop at x naught with alpha. Okay. So if alpha is homotopy to constant loop, and what is happening? Only when you go to omega xa. Therefore, alpha is in the kernel of J check. Okay, when you go to omega xa, it's 0. So one part is over. The second and the converse part, given alpha and pi of xa, suppose J check of alpha is 1. This gives us a homotopy. J check of alpha is 1 means this alpha, when it treated as an element of omega xa, is null homotopy. So take the homotopy. H from I n minus 1 cross I to omega xa from alpha to constant. Okay. Now take G as I n minus 1 cross I to x, given by, I am reversing the roles of what we did in the previous step. G of x t of s is, but little carefully have to do, h of x t s 1 minus t times s plus t. Okay, s as a general factor here, and the constant function 1, constant point, the point 1, has been taken 1 minus t plus 1 minus t of this plus t times that is convex combination of. You have to verify that G defines homotopy of alpha with a map beta given by endpoint, namely beta x of s is nothing but h of x of h x1 of 1. Okay, when this whole thing is 1, that is homotopy of the endpoint. When it operates on 0, that will be the alpha. That's what you have to verify. This means that beta is an element of pi n minus 1 of omega xa, omega a. Okay. Therefore, if alpha is homotopy to I composite beta, it is same thing as I check of beta is alpha. So we have to prove two more steps here. Kernel of DABA equal to image of J check. Okay, so now we are coming here. This part, kernel here is equal to image of J check. Elements are inside pi n of xa. Okay, so if alpha is J composite beta for some beta from I n minus 1 of I n minus 1 into omega x. Okay, then even composite alpha, remember this was this was used in the definition of the DABA, the boundary operator. Even composite alpha, which is the endpoint map, is constant map Cx0, because beta is a loop at x0. This means DABA of alpha is just 1. That means the trivial element is Cx0. Okay, so one way is very easy. Now we have to do converse. Suppose DABA alpha is 1 for some alpha from I n minus 1 to omega x. This means that we have a null homotopy of even composite alpha. Okay, see, even composite alpha may not be a constant function, but it's homotopic to constant function is what we get, okay? It's relative to the boundary. Okay, that is the meaning of that. This is a trivial element in this group. Okay, in minus 1 to A, boundary of in minus 1 going to single point all the time. That is the meaning of this group. All right. So, what we have? We have a null homotopy of even composite alpha from in minus 1 to A. Okay. Let H be such a homotopy. For each fixed x in in minus 1, let us define a path omega x from 0, 1 to A. Okay, omega x is a path operating upon S is H of x, is this homotopy. Then omega x is a path from starting from E1 of alpha x to alpha x of 1. Okay, which is to x naught inside A. Okay, so even of alpha x is not exactly all the time x naught, right? So this is alpha x of 1 by definition. And it is homotopic to constant path, so to x naught you get. Each of them will be, end point will be just x naught. So alpha x1 is some point, and from there I am joining it to x naught. That is the meaning of this one. Omega x is what is, that's what is doing. So now put omega x t of s equal to this omega x t s. Okay, so I'm defining another path here. Okay, temporal path. Now you define h from I n minus 1 cross I to omega x by h of x t equal to first part is alpha x. Remember, this is a path. It ends in alpha x1. So take that point and take omega xt from there. So omega xt starts at alpha 1, alpha x1, and ends at some other point. Okay, so take this path. Okay. I want to say that they are all loops now. What is the end point of this? Is always x0. So starting point is x0, end point is x0. So they are loops. So we have h of x0 is alpha x star cx, okay? Alpha x star cx naught, second point is x is always alpha x. So I have to put 0 here. So alpha x0 is just cx naught. That is the same thing as if you take a constant loop and take alpha x constant loop, constant path, it's always alpha x, right? Homotopic to alpha x. And h of x1 is alpha x star omega x t equal to 1, it is omega x. Remember, what is omega x t of this one? Omega x 0 will be omega x of 0 comma s, whatever s is, it is really 0. Omega x1 will be omega x of just s, it is omega x. Okay, so alpha x star omega x is h of x1. Okay, this we know is an element of omega x. That's why we started with this one. Okay, this is how you started with this. Omega x is this one. Okay, they are all loops. So thus we get a homotopy of alpha with a map beta, which is h of x comma 1 at endpoint. That map is I n minus 1 omega x. It's the alpha endpoint was arbitrary point inside A. From there we took paths going into x naught. So all of them are now loops. And these are homotopy. Therefore, this alpha is in the image of J check now. So this alpha being homotopy to beta, it is an image of J check. So this is a clever proof. It needed some cleverness here, okay? Trick. The third step, kernel of I check equal to image of Daba. This last thing here, kernel of I check is image of Daba. So now elements are inside pi n minus 1 of A. Okay. Let now beta from In minus 1 Sn minus 1 to Ax naught be a map such that beta is in the image of Dava. Then I have to show that I check of that is 0. I check of that is constant function. That's what I have to show, right? So this implies that there is a map alpha from In to omega Xa such that this beta x is alpha x1. That is the definition of that beta belongs to image of Dava. Okay. Putting h of xt equal to alpha of xt. Remember alpha x is a function. So h of xt becomes homotopy. We have h of x naught is equal to alpha x at 0, which is x naught. H of x1 is alpha x1, it's beta x. Hence, beta is null homotopy. The starting point is a constant function and is beta. So, beta is null homotopy in x. Okay. So, that means beta is in the kernel of I check. When you go to I check, I is from A to x, right? Okay. So, one way we have proved. Conversely, suppose you have a homotopy from In cross I to X, okay, to a constant loop at X naught with the map beta. Suppose beta is null homotopic in X, that's the meaning. Then look at alpha from In to omega X given by alpha X of T equal to H of X T, the same homotopy. So that gives you boundary of alpha is equal to beta, because boundary of alpha is evaluation at the end point is beta, starting point is x naught. So that will be a loop in, that will be a path in omega x a, that those are functions omega x. That's a function from In to omega x a. Beta has property, boundary of alpha is beta. So that proves beta is major. Okay, so to be precise, 3 and 1, step 1 were easier. Step 2 was somewhat difficult. But in nature, they are all slightly different. That is why I have taken pain to write down all these proofs. Okay? So go through them carefully. It is not that if you prove that one, other things are similar. This is not the case here. Okay? So go through them carefully. That is the only way to understand the various interrelations here and the definitions and so on, you know, properly. Okay. So we will take a rest here and start the second part of the module 16 a little later. Thank you.